Article 12 which states, in order to achieve maximum cooperation in connection with the matters mentioned, the repairing states will take provided for a chapter at the earlier stage of all. These are also religious legal language. I want to look on the sessions that deals with primary things that you understand. So chapter 3 deals with navigation and transport. Under chapter 2, article 13. The taxes and duties payable by the vessels and goods using the river, therefore shall be in proportion to the services rendered to the navigation and shall in no way be discriminatory. Uniformity. All the nine countries, if they said the sailing time is this, labor law is this, these are the taxes and levies you have to contribute to the commission for it to manage and maintain the river. Because on the river, there will be bridges, there will be several things that they are supposed to manage. So it will be derived from taxes and duties. It should be uniform. If not, some countries should have bullied. Nigeria, for instance, should have been bullying everybody. Yes. So these are all enshrined in the agreement or which later was superseded by the convention. Yes. The River Niger shall establish general regulations to ensure the safety and control of navigation on the understanding that such regulations shall be designed to facilitate as much as possible the movement of vessels and boats. So out of the agreement or the convention, regulations shall be made. So as I said earlier, mother laws are made in jurisdictions. But if you come to implementation of mother laws, you have to enact a secondary law. And some of the secondary laws are called regulations, some are called instruments. And if you please learn it, the public orders given by ministers, I mean, people in charge of agencies and authorities, please, they are all law, secondary law. The bylaws, the MDCC have been passing. If you flout it, they send you to court, you find yourself behind bars. They are all laws. They are all secondary laws. They are not the mother laws. For instance, the MMDCs draw their power to pass bylaws to allow them to generate revenue and work from what? The Local Government Acts of Ghana. So there's one whole big act. So all the 200 something assemblies and district of metropolitan of Menopoli, they can pass their own bylaws to suit their local demand and their locality. So every MMDC knows the economic power of and the locality. So they know Tema, they only know how to go after public and private establishment. We running offices and start collecting, coming to tax end. Yes. Fancy coming to a small micro free forwarding company that you should pay 5,000 Ghana cedis every year. Yes. TMA, they have been doing it and we are always having conflict with them. As of today, GIF have not resolved that issue with them. So these things happen. Money. The general provisions, the agreement shall form an integral part of the Acts of Niamey and shall enter into force immediately after its ratification. So, this just about another river body and its laws. Okay? Another river body and its laws. None of the inland water bodies in the world operates in a vacuum. No. If not, there will be pandemonium on it. Everybody will say, so even the sea that is there is being controlled by the United Nations conventions and laws. So that's why no country, so that if you go, that's why they quickly send you to The Hague, the International Court for Arbitration, they go to The Hague and sort yourself out. Don't stay in your countries and be pulling guns and cutlasses. Like initially what Nigerians were doing to the Cameroonians, because they think they have plenty, they are populous, they have power, they have money. But at the end of the day, peace prevailed and they judge the case in favor of Cameroon. And since then, Nigeria has become quiet. Yes. So these laws governing water bodies that have been created by God bring some sort of sanity. Okay. So when you pick your notes from here, please read them very well. Read you. Some of my questions, I'll ask you to briefly state, explain some of the articles that I've slided to you. Have I duty? I'm just standing here for study's sake. If not, then I'll teach you. I'll be sleeping. Yeah. So, please, that is it. Yes, any questions about this? Laws concerning inland waterways. A typical example, if you look at our own, the Volta Lake, we know the laws governing. So go into those laws too and read it. I think I'm opening a slide that the laws are in there on this machine so that, class rep, if you are copying, I'm going to copy about 3 or 4 slides this week. So you have our own laws. You study your own, then you come and study the Niger River one. So you have to study both. Right? Good. So this clip also ends. What's the time? We'll open another
6:20.
Good. So 1 hour more. Eh? So we pause it. Do not. Then record it. We are going to stop it all together.
Let's pause it.
No, finish.
Let's finish. You
want to wait. Yeah, you want to end it so that we store it forever. No. This is pause. This life is ended. Okay, we need to leave it. Let me record. Yesterday they did that and we lost it. And this, they have to come to the secretariat and record everything for them. But now they try to touch you. This software is more complex. We use the Google Classroom to invest easier. This, I don't know where. Google Classroom is so easy, everybody can do it. You can process it. Hello, Gabby. They are coming.
Okay, that is good. The basic objective is to know the economic benefits of transporting by inland waterway. Therefore, if I should use any inland waterway and you don't put money in my pocket, forget it. Or continue to put on rail or land or the sea. Commercial ability of that is committed. So, like as I said, if they improve the rail you have constructed to Pakistan and you can roll it on